Episode of Russian Fishing 4. We are at Old Burg. We're going to continue to hunt for these perch and pikes. Now, I learned a new spot here. We're going there right now. Hey, Baba, how's it going? So, it didn't give no cords, unfortunately, but the angle where it should be, I believe this is a spot right here. There's also supposed to be grass and black carps here too. But let's confirm. We'll open up something here. Let's see. Hot spots. It looks. It's. You know what? This says it's 34. Dude, you can't see what the heck you posted. 54, 32. Let's see what we're at. 34. I'm gonna guess it's gonna be down that way. Oh, something broke the reel already. That sucks. And as for the, other up here, this is actually the exact same spot. See that? People are catching common carp, grass carps, even black carps. So they are using banana 20 pop-ups and banana flavors. So they're using banana for that part. So did it say where it's clipped at, or did it not? Let's see what we have here. So we gotta go pick up pop-ups. Pop-up method. Decor. We'll use the method feeder. Grass and blacks. Use an extra large hook right here. Banana. Do I have banana? I do not have banana. Okay. It's still early, so let's hurry up and get this. It's actually here. Everything else is sold out in between. So we'll buy at least 20. So 24. 60 for, so 20 for each rod. Banana flavor, yellow. any money on this, won't we? Alright, we'll get it. Hopefully go anywhere else. Then next will be... this must be the dip. Banana strike. Must be a Mad Myers, so this will be here somewhere. Look at that. God dang it. We're gonna have to go to Volkov. Nah. Still spending the money regardless. At least want to have the lines casted before, at least before 9. Because you know how the bite rate for the pikes are after the midday between 11:30 and 12. The pikes stop biting completely, which kind of sucks. Banana strike. Okay, I think that's everything. I want to actually get one more thing here. I'm actually going to buy one more. I'm going to buy a couple of these. I'll explain why here in a second. So under ground baits, the crushed boilies, we want to use the 14 pop-ups, not the 20, because we're going to crush it. Okay. Now we'll come up here to ground bait, try mix. Don't matter what we use. We can use actually, it does matter. Let's see what we got for blackened grass. So hemp seed flour. So we'll use that for the base. And the banana 14 pop-up. The banana 14 crush pop-up additives attractant. I think it should still be saved. I want to basically match it for what we're going to aim for, so we need this right here. We'll add the flaxseed with it too, just give it a boost. Done here, we're going back. we don't have PVA, so we have to make up the difference. I'm going to guess we're probably going to use a maybe clip 10. I have no idea. Based on this here, I think we want to cast up ahead past the lilies at least a little bit. So, banana 20. Banana flavored yellow and banana stripe. We'll try about 15. Did I lock the door? Whoops. I'm gonna change this to the classic pop-up on this one. See what rig is working better. We'll try that one. Nope, that's the wrong one. Set. Okay, next, this one right here we want. Alright, I'm gonna put this over here so it's kind of out of the way. I think we're gonna cast with pikes over here. And it's supposed to be the flying log. 001. I have 001. Up the friction brake a bit. And retrieve speed to 35. Alright. Let's see if we get ourselves some pikes. I make sure I got the right lure on. Whew, that was a hell of a cast. Fish already. First pike gets a marker too. Not a big one, but it'll do. not a fish. This one's small. Might be a perch or a small pike. Might check out that Facebook page here for the hot spots to find out if there was a clip to that or not. There's a fish. There's a perch. Where's a hit? We are finding them, but the small ones. Like right on the edge of this grass. Not a good cast. Okay guys, give me about 5 minutes. I need to find out if there's a clip to this. This is where these carps are at. Okay, hook number. This is posted by a moderator, but they didn't give information about a clip. These are at the wrong spot. 32, 37, 62. I really hate to recast that because that used a whole entire 10 of that bait. Didn't say what clip though, it sucks. It's after noon anyway, so the pike rate is going to be down. It looks like it's going to be right here. I wouldn't say there's a clip even here. Maybe about 10 maybe. Yeah, I would say definitely about a 10. We'll put this at 15. We'll figure it out. Cast this. Alright. I don't see why they had to stand here exactly for the pikes. Why can't? Why don't we just go over here? That way I can keep eye on these lines, just fish for pikes from here. It's kind of same position, just fishing a different angle. I think walking the dog is working better too. Might spend money on the extra flying logs hereafter. Looks like there's a line moving here. It might be the wind though too, look at the wind. You know what, I'm gonna actually put the sound through my headset because I want to hear the bells. There, that's better. fuck, I was able to get the walk and the dog working steady, casting to the right, but it's not. Oh no, I just had a hard hit. You guys seen that? That sucked. Son of a. Okay, so you got a reel at this angle. See it working on the carps and that. Check and see if anything is following it. The hell kind of cast was that? Boy, something grabbed it and hit the water. Pike got caught up. Stupid thing. You guys able to hook a fish too, or track a fish without doing the walk and the dog too. You can just do stop and go. Like, if you're going to not do this, you can just reel and stop. So either way, no matter how you reel the this lure, it works both ways. But yes, doing a technique does give you a better chance. I'm gonna hold off before I go and check that. It started going off, but I'm gonna give it just a little longer. I definitely might be taking a trip to make some potatoes and tea after. You also can do this too. Now, I know most of you guys do not have a jerk rod, so I will do a test here, see if you can catch pike here without using a jerk rod. My go-to lure for if you can do the top water will be the Angry Walker, the green one, or if you don't have that, you can also do the Funky Minnow. Let's go check on that rod here, because it stopped making noises, so it kind of makes me wonder. Also, trying to see which one I'm going to use here. I think it's this one. Yep, the Angry Walker's on here. I think it's going to be over here because this one's kind of way over that way. Or just point out this one. Okay, something might be on this one. The heck we got here? Is it stuck? No, it's not stuck. He's just pulling some. One of the carps we're looking for. Okay. Alright. Angry Walker. We want to cast same direction. This one will go at 35 as well. We're just trying to get that twitching. Or walk the dog as well. That's what you do with this one. You let reel and you let the line slack. Reel, slack. Doing short burst on the reel. Usually some fish like to grab this at the shore. We'll do about 5 casts with this, and about 5 casts with the funky minnow. See if anything will take this. There's one. Alright, 3 more. So far, the Angry Walker only caught one. So this might be a funky middle spot, perhaps. Whoa. Well, there you guys have it. The funky minnow hooked a big fish here. I'm going to have to get around that log. First cast and funky minnow hit something big here. It might hang me up in that freaking stump there. Maybe not. It would have got caught over that log right there if I went ahead and tried to not come over here. Woohoo! That's a nice pike right there. Let's see if we can find another one. Okay, be honest with you, I think this is working better than the that jerk bait. That little guy. Might try a fish piece over here, right along with the with that boilie, see if to catch carp. We may might find something else over here, like eel or a burbot. Okay, we're definitely done with that for now. Put this in place a bit. One of these have something on it. We'll take that reel off. Keep the fish piece on, like I said. I hear line running. That's something good on here, guys. I don't know what it is, but something good. Just whipping line. I'm about to follow it, otherwise I'm gonna burn my drag. This is the first fish I had to go run after on this lake. Nope, he's not ready yet. Thank you. dang it. I gotta get a drink here. Was it 5 or 4? Fish is gonna spoil me somehow. Why'd I had hooked us on the alpha for? Alright guys, I am going to do something here. Never mind. I was gonna go grab a drink of cola, but I'm not gonna risk it. This gotta be a grass. Yeah, He's coming though. Alright, he. Well, at least I kept my night interesting. I thought I was going to not catch nothing. Boy, was I wrong. I'll be more impressed if this is a trophy. But the tension is not that high, it don't make sense. Still wants a fight. The T wore off, that's why. That's a big fish. That is a grass. Kilograms. And that fish fought that long? Alright. What is wrong with on here? Yeah, I don't see a thing that could be causing it. Unless it's this hook. But I don't think that's it. That's 27 kilogram leader here. 22 kilogram carp leader core. And 30 kilogram line. But the reel though. That reel was the reason why it struggled. That's why the tension wasn't so high, but the fish could overpower the drag. Like I said, why did I have to hook that on the alpha for? Check these rods, see if there's anything on them. Nope, nothing on that. Is it this one? Nope. Ain't nothing on these either. Okay. Alright, we'll put this here. Hold on, we got a bite here. Okay, I need to stop using alphas for the carp. Alright, I'm changing this out. that can stay. Where is my other rod? We're all here. Caliber there. And my other caliber. I'm kind of be stuck with one alpha, regardless. You know what? For some odd reason, I cannot see my chat at all. I just noticed you guys chatting and it's not popping up. Are you still there, by the way? Christ, it makes me feel like I'm ignoring you guys and I'm sitting there, I had to exit the video and reopen it, then I see all people chatting. One of these lines gotta come out. It's gonna have to be this one right here. Change this to, I'll change this to classic pop-up, keep that on. I'm so disgusted with this damn YouTube. Don't know why I keep doing this. This is not assembled yet. More confident this way, I actually hold something. Right. Keep those in the water. Yes, if this is the case, I'm going to use a funky middle instead of the other one. And if that is the case, also, I think Babinox should switch from his, from the jerk to this. Cause it seemed like it makes sense. Oh yeah, I gotta put this back to 35, otherwise it ain't gonna work. So how are you doing there, Baba? Was it Baba? Baba Nui? I only noticed that the chat don't work if I actually schedule the stream. It's like I have to basically open the video or YouTube after I launch it, not before. Okay, so far nothing off the funky middle. Don't think it's too early, so I don't know what's the deal. Alright, you take it easy, and thank you for stopping by. I also apologize for how YouTube basically wasn't working. Might try a different lure here. So we got here. Oops, what the hell went on? Why did I grab that for? I also bought this one. Never really had much luck on it. It's fairly new. It kind of got like a oil type color to it, like, you know, how oil sits on top of the water. Maybe the jerk baits work in the morning and then. How come this rod? One of these ain't work. Come on, grab it. Did I not cast something? Oh. Move that all the way. Because it's confusing the hell out of me. No fish on there.
I'll give it a little longer. Whoa, here we go. So maybe the funky middle works at in the evening and the jerks works at in daytime, maybe in the morning. Looking that way so far. I'm not even doing walking a dog, I'm catching fish. I notice a fish like to grab it as soon as it stops. It's like how you do the stop and go technique. But it don't pop, don't show up though. it's getting close to noon. That's why no fish are biting right now. But I did thought of something, though. I can always change this to the lure rig. And put my funky middle on here. Should still work the same. You know, I can't really cast that far, but this definitely would actually do good for fighting these larger pikes, though. This is a very light lure for this rod, so that's why I can't really cast that far on here. So I'll put this back as on the jerk part. I thought I said like the flying log, the 001. S. See how nice this one casts? Okay, I'm just gonna do the walk and the dog. It seems like it's harder to catch fish right now. Down. Sure wait a while for his bite, eh? Well, so far, both fishing spots are working. I'll just keep using this one. This one has been working. As you guys see how much wear is on this lure. Should try, hopefully find another pike over 7 kilograms, then the possibility of that 7 kilogram pike order up, then I have a chance of getting that order done. That cast way back there, like right in the other side of that moss back there. Okay, I'm just gonna do it this way because I'm not catching anything off walking the dog. Probably still got another 5 minutes before they start biting again. Alright, so this ain't working. I'm going to switch to this one, and I'll put the other lure back on. Ah, damn snag. Okay, so the perches are coming out now. It's starting to cloud up and I'm catching perch, but was during the sun or clear weather, I was actually hooking pike. So that tells you something. Ain't supposed to. Okay, when it starts to rain, you could change your lure. Go ahead and use your hunter here. And you're gonna drop the speed down to about 20. Cast like you normally do. You can do like a few reels and let it hit the bottom. Or just trying to do the jig step. The only dangers of using a spoon here is getting snagged a lot. That literally cast right into the grass over there. Might take a trip to Burg off and let's see here. Lots of rain there too, but I want to check out the lures. Obvious, the spoon's not working. Could try, let's see here. This lure. This lure, you gotta raise the speed to about 40. That's how you get the walk and the dog to work properly with this lure. Going back to the funky minnow, because this is where I caught that 9 kilogram. Okay, it's good. We got two fish on it now. Now, I know there's a fish on here. I heard it go off. Nothing there, see? Alright, let's check the cafe here. There's a pike order here, but hold on a minute. How much? I don't doubt that 9 is worth anything over 100. $49 and $16. So yeah, this definitely is worth more than selling it outright. 120 silver. Only caught 2 perch. Alright. We'll sell the rest of the fish. $106, so I got about at least found 230 some silver. Alright, let's go to Volkov. Check that flying log. $95. I don't know if I can even lift that lure here. Actually, it would be just at the size. That's a heavy lure, though. Flying log 001. I think that's what the guy said. 17. Yep. All right. Expensive lure, but
Heavy, Jesus.
Oops, wrong one.
That's a big lure, I tell you.
We'll go over to that island over there in a minute and see if we can find any, any eels and burbots. Okay. I'm already at clip 10, so I don't have to change nothing. Okay, I got the right stuff then. This one. Cast way too far, I think. Man, it's this one right here then. Yeah, that went way too far. Okay, I'm gonna put this over here. This one stay in the center. Obviously, he's catching him. We'll just have to wait. Little guy. There we go. When you pick the damn fish up. That's too like a small fish. Didn't really pull that hard. I don't know what's going on with this one. This one had no bites at all the whole entire time. Okay, I need to find out the difference with this one. This one's catching him steady. This one's exact same everything, and exact same hook. Same hook. So why is this one getting all the fish and not those? What if the fish is over here instead? I'm just thinking. We'll head back at 8, to try out that lure. I feel it's too heavy, but I don't know. That's a big burbot. Holy. Ah, forget. I can't spell with crap. still feel that I can probably get one more fish before it's completely done. I really don't want to waste no time, though. Oh yeah, let's check, cafe orders here. We got some nice bourbon here. No orders up for that, so. $5.90. 22 silver for that fish right there. Alright, let's head back to Old Burg. See if that lure works. Kind of want to do something quick. I actually want to put this in place because this helps raise energy. Stand right here and cast. Freaking big old lure.
I just feel this lure is like overkill. I just feel this lure is too big. So far, no luck on this lure at all. But yeah, watch, I'll switch back to the lure I've been using. Watch it start getting fish. I just think this lure is not going to work. Whoa! That fish just grabbed that as a real one. Speed reeling, maybe? Do a short cast. That might have been a fluke. I'm gonna actually go down here a little bit. I think the fish are right over here in this moss.
Alright, so almost every single cast is hooking to a fish. I might try that big lure again. Maybe I might hook into something really big here. Or could have bought the same color as I'm using. Definitely not getting anything off this big lure at all. See, this lure keeps working. I just cast that at a good spot at all. Right in the open water. I was trying to cast over there along the grass and the tall weeds, or what they call it. I think these pikes like to hit fast movement. Gotta be a wind pulling me somewhere. Cause I keep missing where I want to cast. I don't think it really matters. I'm getting pike regardless. Oh, that's a that's a good sized pike. I can catch these all day long. So it seems I really don't want to cast into that tall grass. I think I want to cast on the side of it. I think the wind keeps grabbing my lure. There's a nice one. There we go, that's where I want to cast at. Them final fish back there this time. Nice one. Another marker, it feels. least I'm casting at the right spot this time. That's too far. I might find a pike back there, but I think I cast too far to the right. It pikes hit the damn log so hard. I'm surprised they ain't got any memory left. It'd be like rum dumb. Ooh, that was a nice hit. What the hell was that about? Well, I don't see nothing wrong with the computer stats. Everything seems fine. The perch is starting to come out. Night is clear, so now it's going to start slowing down again. Cloudy too, it might rain. For a couple more casts. I think I got enough time for at least one or two. That's a little one. I might have snagged this one. What? It's a perch. That might have been not a good cast. Alright, let's go see how much we made this time around. $154 silver. That's not bad. We actually did pretty good this time around. Well, anyways, I am going to end the video here. If you guys liked the video, please hit the like button. You guys want, you guys should subscribe as well if you guys haven't done so already. I thank you for the support, and I thank you guys for watching. I will see you all next time. Bye.